great moments in music. Program of fine music with distinguished singers of the Metropolitan Opera Company, the orchestra and chorus under the direction of George Sebastian, and rebroadcast especially for the servicemen and women of the United Nations.
Good evening. This is Jean Tennyson. In just a moment, you will hear a special program, Walt Whitman, Here's America. I say special because our music and narration tonight reflect those things nearest our hearts, the land we love, the freedom we enjoy, the boys and girls who are fighting for us all over the world to preserve the greatest thing in the world, our homes, our children, our America.
My tan-faced children, follow well in order. Get your weapons ready. Have you your pistols? Have you your sharp-edged axes? Pioneers, oh pioneers, we the youthful sinewy racers, all the rest on us depend. Pioneers, oh pioneers.
I beg your pardon. Who are you?
Walt Whitman's my name.
Walt Whitman, the poet?
Poet, yes, I guess so. I hope you don't mind my dropping in from limbo, unannounced and unexpected. But when I heard that song, I Hear America Singing, you know those words of mine, I just couldn't help wondering about the occasion. So I came to find out and maybe join in.
And it's indeed a pleasure to have you join us, and an honor. We all know you and know what you stand for.
I never tried to hide that. I made my poems and songs out of the stuff that is America. And lately, I've been thinking a lot about these United States of ours.
Whatever you say will always interest us, Walt, because you wrote a great deal about this country.
Well, some folks say that Walt Whitman couldn't open his mouth without a mountain or a valley dropping out. Maybe so. But behind the mountains and valleys are the people. And I came by to remind you about that. Figured you might have lost sight of that.
We'll try not to, Walt.
Oh, I see that this flashing America is only you and me. Its power, weapons, testimony are you and me. Past, present, future are you and me. What do you think endures? Do you think a great city endures? I see beyond my beloved Manhattan the open road leading to the Valley of Rivers and beyond the prairies. The shapes arise. Shapes of factories, foundries, pastures and forests, railroads and commerce. I see men and women dancing in the streets of their city. Listen. I hear music of the Mardi Gras in New Orleans.
Thank you.
I see now beyond the spinal river, the free fresh giver, the Mississippi. I see beyond the thunder of shipyards and commerce, where the land levels to the prairie and goes on under the bright blue bowl of sky. I see the great plains stretching to the Rockies. There is wheat here, the fruitfulness of earth, land of the wagon routes, the old prairie schooners, land where the buffalo once roamed, plunging toward the sunsets of the west. The buffalo are gone, but there's cattle here and men to tend them.
Howdy, stranger.
Howdy.
Come from far?
A piece back. New Orleans. Things are stirring there. Shipyards going full blast.
I suppose. Lots of cowhands like me ran off for those jobs. Few of us had to stay on. I decided to stay.
Short-handed, I reckon.
See those herds grazing?
Mm-hmm.
Just a small percent of the total. Short-handed for a big job. There are folks that think cowboys dress up fancy-like and play a guitar all day long. Well, maybe they did once, but now there's a war on. We gotta produce.
We don't hear much about this part of the country.
No, you won't find any launchings with champagne or parades. We get out the food, though. We turn out the leather for boots and military equipment. Lots of lend-lease in the panhandle. We got our trademark on stuff in Britain, China, and Russia. Kind of proud of that. Man feels part of the war. And sometimes out here when it's quiet, you almost forget the war.
The war can't stop a man from harking back to an earlier time. Now, I can remember when the cowboy was a hard-riding, hard-drinking, one-man pioneer. And there'd be songs about him. Pretty songs.
Chuck's partner, it ain't no different now. We still got the songs. Still cut quite a figure, mind you. One song in particular I recollect was pretty. It had a real pretty melody.
I'm a roving cowboy, far away from home, far from the prairie where I used to roam, where the dogies wander and the wind blows free. Oh, my heart is yonder on the lone prairie. Carry me back to the lone prairie, where the coyotes howl and the wind blows free. And when I die, you can bury me 'neath the western sky on the lone prairie. Give me back my saddle, give me back my gun, give me back that bronco that I used to run. Let me spread my blanket by a peaceful stream, hear the cowboys singing by the campfire's gleam. Oh, carry me back to the lone prairie, where the coyotes howl and the wind blows free. And when I die, you can bury me 'neath the western sky.
The shapes of democracy arise, of rivers, of iron and steel, of man's labor. Yet there are shapes of things more intimate, and these are America, too. The shapes of houses at the day's ending. I see the lights throughout the land burning softly at eventide. The cluster of lights which are the cities, and the lights thinning out toward the loneliness of farms and hills. I see the farmer herding his cattle to the barns. I see the worker leaving his bench and returning home. I see the resting of multitudes for tomorrow's task. The earth is still. America comes home. Have died for a good cause. The seed is spare. Nevertheless, the crop shall never run out. America's men are fighting men, and poets too. Over the thunder of battle, I hear the soldier singing. I hear the words of his own poet and general, George S. Patton, voicing in his own words the credo of the soldier. The soldier is articulate in hymns of prayer to the God of battle.
Break out through the ages.
counsel, but not in cringing guise. We whine not for thy mercy, to slay God make us wise. For slaves who shun the issue, we do not ask thy aid. To thee we trust our spirits, our bodies unafraid.
From doubt and fearsome boding, till thou our spirits guard.
Make strong our souls to conquer, give us victory, O Lord.
Your name, please?
WALT WHITMAN.
First time as a blood donor?
Yes, ma'am.
Hold this card until your name is called. Sit right here next to this young lady.
Thank you. Hello.
Hello.
Looks like you and I are the first customers this morning. You frightened?
Oh, no, of course not.
I am. This is all new to me. Mighty new.
The first time is always a bit scary. But after
that... Oh, you been here before?
This is my fifth blood donation. I feel it's going to him personally. I feel it might save him.
Good news?
Oh, this letter?
Yes.
It's an old letter. Over a year old. I keep it with me all the time. I must have read it 1,000 times. A letter makes you feel he's still alive.
My dear child, he may be.
He was at Salerno. And this was his last letter. Do you like my engagement ring?
It's lovely.
You see, we were going to be married. I used to cry a lot at first, but now I just wait. I remember it was spring when he left.
When lilacs last in the dooryard bloomed, and the great star early dropped in the western sky in the night, I mourned, and yet shall mourn with ever-returning spring, and thought of him whom I love.
How beautiful that is.
It was written for Abe Lincoln, but it may be spoken for anyone who is our beloved. You may say it within your heart, child, and believe he will return, never to leave your side again. Let it be as a song within you. Let it be a secret within you.
Take my place beside you, smiling through the years. Through the years, I'll keep my place beside you, smiling through your tears. I'll be near, no matter when or where. Star to guide you, shining bright, though clouds may come and hide you, through the years, here love is gone, and time first disappears. I'll come to to guide you, shining bright, the clouds may come and hide you through the
years. Here and love is gone. And time first disappears. I'll come to you, smiling through the years.
Through the years. Through the long, long years of yesterday, the tortuous years of today, each of us fights and builds for the towering future of America. We work to perpetuate the green American hills and rolling plains, the industry, farms, and lusty cities, the great good people of our land, the spirit of unfettered freedom that is our national vigor. That is the America for which our men and women today are...
Main shapes arise. Shapes of democracy, bracing the earth and braced with the earth. I announce what comes after. I announce justice triumphant. I announce uncompromising liberty and equality. I announce the Union more and more compact. I announce splendors and majesties to make all the previous politics of the earth insignificant. Others adorn the past. But you, old days of the present, I adorn you. Old days of the future, I believe in you. Oh, America, because you build for mankind, we build for you.
Mine eyes have seen the coming of the glory of the Lord.
He is tramping up the vintage where the grapes are ripe.
He has loosed the fateful lightning of his terrible swift sword.
His truth is marching on.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
His truth is marching on.
He has sounded voice of comfort that shall never.
Next week at the same time, we will bring you great moments from Puccini's La Boheme with Jan Pierce, Gene Tennyson, Earl Wrightson, and the chorus and orchestra under the direction of George Sebastian. Here is Jan Pierce singing one of your favorites. You will hear all of your favorites from La Boheme next week when we again present Great Moments in Music. This is the Armed Forces Radio Service.